Okay, he's telling me that you lot are confused, didn't it? I'm confused myself because the guy told me that Jesus is described as his tan and he's got cotton hair. So I'm confused now. And outside my house is Jesus with 8 packs and he's white. No, honestly, I'm not confused. But let them speak. Be respectful. Let them speak.
Go on.
What is it called? Let's say he was black.
Okay.
What does it say to you?
What do you mean? What does it say? Relax, Mr. Man.
Why are you so sure?
It's part of the
famous.
Yeah.
I don't want to be famous.
Okay, step aside.
Everyone will know you.
Step aside. All right, go on. Sorry, I need a question. Go on.
Let's say, sake of the argument, first of all, let's make it clear.
Yeah.
Bible doesn't tell us the color of Jesus.
Okay.
But there are a couple of things Bible tells us.
Yes.
Bible tells us Jesus is the one who gives eternal life.
Yeah.
Bible tells us Jesus is the only way to Father.
Okay.
I'm asking a simple question.
Yeah. I'm asking you the simple question.
Let's say...
You're describing the attributes and the qualities of Jesus, but what about his skin color? Did he have long hair? Did he have short hair? Did he have 8 packs? Okay, sorry.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah, because outside my house, sorry, darling. Outside my house, there's a big cross here. I can exchange numbers with you and I'll WhatsApp you, yeah? There's a big cross here with Jesus standing like this and he's got 8 packs.
It doesn't matter for me.
Okay, it's true, yeah?
If Jesus was black, or white. He was white.
Okay.
For me, what he claimed about himself and what is the application to my life.
Okay.
So I'm asking you a very simple question.
Okay.
Sake of the argument,
okay.
Jesus is the way you are describing.
Okay.
What is the implication of that to you?
Okay.
Because I do have different concerns
okay.
for Muslims beside the color of Jesus.
So you're telling me that it's not important whether it's white or black?
Okay,
it doesn't matter. So I'm coming back to your question now, and I'm answering you. What about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Okay, whether it's white or black, his qualities and attributes, everything you describe about Jesus is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Humbleness and everything that you describe.
He freed the slaves. We don't care whether Ali. He's Arab. He's half Qurani.
He knows the whole Qurani. Honestly, yeah. He's just shy now. No, there's no which Quran, there's only one Quran. Why is Quran? There's no which Quran. She's the best. She said which Quran, you know. No, that's the Iranian Quran. That's the Iranian Quran.
Oh, so there are different Quran.
In Iran. The Shia.
So there are different Qurans.
Yes, in Iran there's the Shia's Quran and Allah. I'll help you out.
Shia is Yusuf's Quran. So that's not what I'm talking about. I'm asking. So if you are hapless,
yeah.
If you memorize
Mashallah,
the Quran,
yeah.
You should able to just know what is the harsh Quran, what is the soft Quran, what is the Kalun Quran. And you should able to answer which one you memorize. So in that case, am I right to assume that you lied when you said you were the hapless of the Quran?
He's obviously shy.
He doesn't want to take his sit down. Maybe he's wanted. You never know. Maybe he has his tie on a job center. They're going to ask him. He said to the job center, so you hear me? So let him talk. You can hear him clearly. Exactly. You can hear him clearly. But there's no such thing as 3 Quran, 4 Quran. It's not the Bible here.
I'm not talking about the 3 Quran. You introduced your brother. As the Hafiz.
Yeah, mashallah. Alhamdulillah, mashallah. No, honestly, he is.
Sadly, doesn't even know what is Hafiz Quran, what is Kalun Quran, what is Duri Quran, what is the Forsh
Quran.
That's
all man made.
So,
isn't it?
What is the Halal Quran? So, that is a bit shame because he doesn't know the basics as he memorized the Quran. But my question still comes to you regarding as you question the color of Jesus. Okay? So, it is important to me what does Muhammad teach about the colors? Because Jesus never said, that guy is white, that guy is black, let's treat them the way because of their skin colors. But Muhammad was supposed to be the example to all mankind for all the times. teach something against that.
He degraded black people.
He degraded who? Black people.
Oh, he didn't say.
He freed Bilal. And Bilal was black. Yeah, he blacker black. Than me. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. No, no, okay, let's just clarify. Let's just
clarify. Do you know about that?
So, Bilal.
Yeah.
He was the first guy who said the azan. Isn't that correct? Because he defeated the Moors. So, can you just tell me when you said he freed? When you said he freed, can you just tell me how many slaves he exchanged Bilal for?
It's part of the game, isn't it? Obviously, back in the days, that's how it worked, maybe, isn't it? That's how it worked, right? Isn't it?
Maybe he went there with money.
I don't know. I don't know. I have to ask Ali Dawa for this, innit? I'm not
Ali Dawa? He's worse.
No.
That guy's more dumb.
Maybe he went there with money and they said, no, we rather exchange with slaves. You can't cut that out, innit?
It's amazing.
Really,
it
you can't cut
amazing.
That out.
It's black.
That you are trying to justify an ugly act. And you are trying to justify. You said, Bilal was free.
Yeah.
He wasn't freed, he was exchanged for other human beings.
Okay.
That is wrong. And it is especially wrong when it is come to us from man who's supposed to be example to whole mankind.
Okay.
So my question is, I have deeper questions beside the color of Muhammad or color of Jesus. So I understand that Muslims are believe something called Tawhid, oneness of Allah. Okay?
I am confused.
And listen, if you think you're confused, why don't you share something and tell her that? You can't just say.
Listen.
No, but this is the whole point of debating, isn't it? It's a park. You listen. You share your views, isn't it? Right? She's telling me something about colouring and the Muhammad and the snake. Why don't you go to her and say you're wrong because it's like this is the bad that. No, how do you know? Are you gonna say no?
Listen, I haven't heard anything. Let me hear something.
She's been polite, man. The way you lot are moving is not right.
I'll smile and then that will make you more polite.
No. You know what she said to me? She said to me, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam freed Bilal and exchanged him for the next man.
Not with money.
So do you know the ayah for that?
Hey sir, come on man, we're debating, come closer.
I am here. If you think I'm making you confused, please do enlighten me.
You don't want to talk anymore?
No, I don't know, they don't want to talk anymore. I was just listening to be honest with you because you don't.
Okay. I'm gonna ask you last very simple question. If you believe in a Tawhid, oneness of Allah, can 100%? Can you just give me the qualifications of the something or someone to be intercede? You know what is the word intercede?
Of course I do. Right.
But sometimes people don't understand from my pronunciation, so that's why. Okay. So what kind of attributes? Something. Let's say Allah or my brother or this gentleman, if they are going to intercede,
we're talking about a different topic. We're talking about race, now we're coming to Allah.
Because I told you why I'm coming to this topic. I don't care the color of Jesus. I do care about his teachings and his claims. They affect my eternity. As a Muslim, you should concern about the color of Muhammad and his teachings. Because it is very ugly and you try to justify.
Now you're being rude. The color of Muhammad, as in the skin?
I would love and
as in his quality or his skin?
And I would love you to.
What skin color is Muhammad? Sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Okay. And I understood from the comments you made that you didn't know Bilal has been exchanged for other human beings for him to be free. That's not a free, that's his was exchanged. So from the conversation I understood that you don't know that much about that topic. Is that correct?
That topic, what you're saying, you're adding more. You're adding a story on top of a story.
Bilal has been exchanged?
No, there's no such thing as exchange.
Okay, in that case, can I encourage you to check that information out?
Okay.
We talk about it next week, okay?
No, we won't talk about it next week, What we'll do is I'll quickly fetch my guy right there.
Okay, you go and get that
guy. Bring him here again.
Yeah. And then I'll tell you why I moved to the Tawhid. Because, color of Muhammad and color of Jesus is not important to
me. It's not important to us at all. You're right.
It's supposed to be important to you because it makes a comment on it.
How?
So you will go and when you bring your brother, we will discuss that.
How is it important to Muslims? Muslims that come in different form, different colors, different sizes, like different areas. It's not important to us.
I know they come from different color, different size,
so it's not really
different
important
shapes,
to us.
But teachings of Islam comes in one shape and one color.
Okay.
And that's not really nice thing to say about it. But I'll beg you to bring your brother. Yeah. I'm happy to have discussion on that.
Okay. Okay.
So my questions are something more deeper.
Okay.
Because I understood that Muslims are teaching there is something called Tawhid, oneness of Allah.
That's right.
And then I do concern the way you are teaching and deceiving people. That's why I want to talk about it. That's why I'm asking you,
okay,
what kind of attributes something or someone must have to intercede for mankind.
Okay, let me stretch him now, yeah? Yeah, go, just stretch him,
I'll give you 2 minutes. If you don't come back, I'll see you next week, okay?
No,
give you 2 minutes.
Okay, I'll fetch Ali.